talking about why MagSafe is the past and the future. In case you didn't know, the chargers for the pre-2015 MacBooks were called MagSafe, and they looked like this. This is MagSafe, the original form. Apple moved away from MagSafe in 2015 to help introduce USB-C. I've said in the past that I believe that USB-C is the future of wired connection. What I mean by this is that what I foresee for the future is anytime you need to plug one thing in to another thing, it'll be a USB-C cord. Anytime you're gonna put wired connection, it's USB-C. Every other port can be replaced with USB-C. It's universal, Ethernet, HDMI, Lightning, USB-A, power audio, everything. It's just that powerful. MagSafe on MacBooks had its issues. If this $80 charger got it all damaged, it was another $80 to like get your computer working again. This is proprietary. You can't go buy one of these at some store. USB-C is universal. That's what the U stands for. The whole point of MagSafe was so that if someone trips on the cord to your computer, your whole computer doesn't get yoinked off the table. USB-C doesn't lock in so securely that this is an issue. Also, they got rid of MagSafe to make the MacBooks thinner and more powerful. One USB-C port is as powerful as all the ports on pre-2015 MacBook, and the new MacBook Pro has four of those. So if USB-C is so powerful that it can replace Lightning on the iPhone, why hasn't it? Why have they brought back this rebranded version of MagSafe for charging the iPhone? Why do I say that USB-C is the future of wired connection? Because the future is also wireless. Apple could change the port again on the iPhone, make everyone mad that's buying the new iPhone because they have to switch, just to remove the port entirely in a few years. Yes, Apple is working on removing the port completely from the iPhone in favor of wireless charging. So will they remove the port from the MacBook? Not as soon as the iPhone, but probably eventually. The MacBook still needs the power of a ported charging cord. But beyond USB-C, I think the future is wireless charging in every surface. As I was writing the notes for this video, I was sitting at Dunkin' Donuts with my iPad on the table and my iPhone on the table, my Tile and keys. I think in the future, there are gonna be wireless chargers all through the table, standard, to charge my iPad, my iPhone, my Tile, or in the future, AirTags. But currently, wireless chargers are limited to, you have to put it right in the middle, and that's the beauty of MagSafe. It forces you to put the charger right exactly where it needs to be. No one has yet been able to make one where you can place it anywhere. I'm not including the, I think it's Xiaomi made one where it like moves the thing around. So I'm not including that, that doesn't really count. Apple said they were gonna do it, and they didn't deliver. If Apple tried and couldn't do it, I don't think anyone can right now. But I believe we'll get there eventually, but for now, MagSafe is the best workaround. For the foreseeable future, USB-C should be the standard and universal port, and for portless devices, Qi chargers are what we have. And the best Qi charging experience is with the MagSafe charger from Apple with the iPhone 12s. That's about all I have for you. Just as a little PS to the video, I didn't know where else to put this in the video, but the MagSafe wallet and other MagSafe accessories are a great way for Apple to get people to accept Qi and MagSafe charging because they made it so easy to place and remove the accessories to your iPhone that it doesn't interfere with wireless charging.